Glycemic index explained, coming right up. Hey, I'm Dr. Ekberg with Wellness for Life, and if you'd like to truly master health by understanding how the body really works, make sure that you subscribe and hit that notification bell so that you don't miss anything. By now, you've probably heard of the term glycemic index, but what is it and what's really a good number to look for? So first of all, glycemic index is a measurement of how quickly something that you eat turns into sugar and how quickly it is absorbed into the bloodstream and results in increased blood sugar levels. So glycemic means sugar. If you start looking for these different values and you find all these different values, then it's because everyone is different. And this is not some scientific standard, it's a trial and error. You give one person some food, you measure their blood glucose, and you see what happens, and something completely different could happen in another person. So I wouldn't go looking too hard in investigating this because I think it is of limited value, but nevertheless, it's a good idea to understand conceptually. Another important factor is that we rarely eat one food by itself. So while I don't recommend a lot of baked potatoes, it is a big difference if you eat the baked potato dry and you scoop it out and leave the skin behind, you're gonna have an astronomical glycemic index. Whereas if you drench it in sour cream and butter, now the butter and sour cream is gonna buffer the body's response. It's going to make it absorb slower and lower the glycemic index. So the number is not a truth in itself, but it's a good thing to understand. So when they make these measurements in people, they use glucose as the standard. So glucose is pure sugar, the way it appears in the bloodstream. So when they make these measurements on people, they use glucose as the reference because glucose is the form of sugar that circulates in your blood. It's a pure 6-carbon ring of sugar. That's the way that your body ultimately uses it once it's getting the bloodstream. So if you eat pure glucose, which is the same thing as dextrose or grape sugar, then that number is 100. By comparison, sucrose or table sugar, which is half glucose and half fructose, will rank at 68 because fructose is absorbed a whole lot slower and therefore the number will be significantly less. So then you look at things like wheat bread and baked potatoes and French fries that some people think are good complex carbohydrates, and you find that they raise your blood sugar more than if you were to take a bag of sugar and eat that white crunchy stuff straight out of the bag with a spoon. Then you would raise it at a number of 68. If you eat wheat bread, baked potato, or French fry, you raise it by over 75 in some cases. So when we talk about sugar, we don't just talk about pure sugar. We talk about the things that turn into sugar. Any carbohydrate at all, anything from the plant kingdom, is going to turn into sugar. Some things turn into sugar almost immediately, and some turn very, very slowly. So if you look at asparagus, spinach, tomato, broccoli, those are non-starchy vegetables. They have a lot of water, a lot of fiber, and a little bit of sugar in them, and the fiber slows things down. So their glycemic index is very low. It's in the single digits. So these are foods that even though they are carbohydrates, they're non-starchy, and you can eat these in any amount that you want. They're not going to screw you up. And then for comparison, obviously, which is never included in any glycemic index table, and it sort of makes sense, but because they don't have any carbohydrate in them, so their glycemic index is close to zero, but it's almost like they don't know that people eat these things. They only focus on the grains and the potatoes and the cereals. But meat, fish, eggs are close to zero in glycemic index. Again, meaning you can eat as much as you like and not have any glycemic, any blood sugar responses. So it's not entirely true because everything you eat does impact blood sugar a little bit, but it is very, very limited. So if you followed our channel for a little while, you know that we promote a diet of low carbohydrate, moderate protein, and high fat, such as a paleo or a keto diet. And then we focus on vegetables and meat and high quality fats, all of which are very, very low on the glycemic index list. Generally, a high glycemic index is considered anything above 70. Medium is considered 56 to 70, and a low glycemic index is considered anything below 56. And anyone working with paleo or keto and has some clinical experience of diet work and nutrition work would probably agree that that's outrageous. So these are not absolute guidelines, but just to give you an idea of where I think they should be, I think a low glycemic index is below 10. I think a medium would be 10 to 30. You'd get some semi-starchy vegetables in there. And high would be anything over 30. Those things will impact your blood sugar significantly. So just for fun, to kind of put this in perspective, I would say that the thing that they call low, I would call super high. What they call medium, I would call crazy high. And what they call high is just pure sugar bombs. So realize that the guidelines have been put together by the same people who promote the food pyramid, and that in this country we have an epidemic of diabetes and degenerative problems that are just going completely out of control. And it's not going to get any better as long as we think that this is the guideline. So thanks so much for watching. If you enjoy this sort of content, make sure that you subscribe and hit that notification bell. And please share this content because this information is life-saving. Tell as many people as you want so we can help people understand how health really works. Thanks for watching.